मैं
मॉर्निंग,
ऑडिबल
गुड
ना हूँ।
मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग। सो वी विल हैव जस्ट रिवीजन ऑफ हैडसेट एंड विल एंटर इनटू लिंक्ड हैडसेट नाउ। नाउ वी जस्ट हैव अ रिवीजन ऑफ हैडसेट। नाउ एज अ हायरार्की वी नो दैट इट इज अ हैडसेट क्लास इज अ चाइल्ड ऑफ अ सेट इंटरफेस एंड देयर आर सम की पॉइंट्स टू बी गेट अंडरस्टूड रिगार्डिंग द हैडसेट। दैट इज द हैडसेट क्लास इज यूज्ड टू क्रिएट अ कलेक्शन दैट यूज अ हैश टेबल फॉर स्टोरेज। Now, what is exactly the hash table? I will share a link after what is exactly the hash table and how it is being stored. It inherits the abstract set class and implements set interface. We already know that this is a class which is inherited from abstract set class and it is just a child of a set interface. So these are the two major things, important thing, that is abstract set as a super class of this hash set class, and this is an interface from which it has been inherited. Now, one of the most important points of hashset we have to understand is that hashset stores the elements by using a mechanism called hashing. Now, this is a technique of storing an element in the hashset. So, this concept I will share you after the session, how this hashing is, then this is a 10-15 minutes video, and how this hashing is working for adding an element into this hashset. The second important thing is that hashset contains unique elements only. So, we don't allow the repeated elements to get added into the hashset. That is the second most important thing. So first is the mechanism of adding. Second one, the unique elements are added. Third one, it also allows null values. You can add a null value also, which is not possible in the previous array list or a linked list. You cannot add a null value, but in hashset you can add a null value also. So this is again the most important thing of hashset. Then hashset is non-synchronized. It is not. No, it is non-synchronized. You cannot do the operations like previous synchronous, like a threading, multi-threading program cannot be done on this hashset. That is most important. Then hashset doesn't maintain the insertion order. So the sequence, what we have seen yesterday, the order in which we have added and the output what we received after displaying the elements, it was something different, because here we have using some different mechanism of adding the element into the hashset. So this is most important. So the sequence, you cannot predict what is the sequence. So for that, you should know the mechanism, the algorithm of hashing. Then hashset is the best approach for search operation. So actually, when we want to search the element and when we want to do a programming where it is focusing on the element values and its searching mechanism, a fast searching mechanism is required, and that situation hashset is used. Now the default capacity of hashset by default, it is 16. By default, the hashset capacity, this need to be written somewhere in a book, and you should memorize that there is only the size which is defined by the hashset. That is minimum default capacity is 16, and local factor is 0.75. So what is load factor? Load factor is for the time required for the executing is load factor. So it is 0.75. So you in this thing, what is most important? It is following some algorithm called as hashing. It don't allow the repeated values to be added, so unique values are added. It can add a null value. It is non-synchronized, and the mechanism of insertion and displaying the product, the element is somewhat different. And the approach is most probably used for the purpose of searching an application. And the capacity by default is 16, and load factor is 0.75. Now we have already gone through this hierarchy of how it is different from the list and set. As we know that it is a set, the abstract set which is working, this is a class, and from this class this has inherited a new concept called the hash set. As far as definition is concerned, it is public class hash set that extends abstract set and implements set, comma, clonable. So you can go for clones, for creating a clones of this class also, and serializable also. You can go for serialization also. So the difference between list and set is most important. That is, list can contain duplicate elements, whereas set contains unique elements only. So there is the basic difference between list and set. And the hierarchy we have already seen. This is the hierarchy. So iterable, collection, set, then abstract class, set class, and this is hash set. So this is the hierarchy and the basic difference between the list and set. Now these are the constructors you can use. That is, we have seen the example of creating hashset that is default. But when you go for default hashset, automatically the capacity becomes 16. But if you want to do some manipulation, you want some limited set of capacity of your hashset, you want 10 or 15 or 25 or 100, You can use the headset capacity also. And load factor, you can add a load factor also. So it is used to initialize the capacity of the headset, the given integer value capacity, and the specific load factor. So we can give a load factor also, and we can give the capacity also. So headset is used to initialize the headset by using the element of collection. So you can add a collection different list, you can add directly. So any class which is present in collection framework can be added directly in the headset. And you can use the addAll function to add all the elements. So you can add from external list also. You can create a list, a headset with the capacity and with the factor. You can explicitly change the capacity of the headset also. And by default, whenever you are creating a headset, the default size is automatically 16. So that should be the understandable part of this headset. Now, as far as functions are concerned, we have already seen in the previous repeated functions are being used. So add function, clear function, clone for the purpose of cloning repeated elements, contains for searching an element, is empty to check whether the headset is empty or what, iterator to retrieve the elements at its place by retrieving its place by using the function called iterator, and its return type is iterator. Okay, then remove function. After removing function, it will display the boolean values, that is true or false. So remove function will be removing the elements. Size function will be displaying the size of the headset. And split iterator. Now this will go for example of split iterator, how it has been used. We have ample number of examples. So split iterator is also used for the purpose of iteration. So the example what we have seen yesterday was very simple. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the output we get is 5. F5 is displayed first. Just a bit.
So hashing is the technology mechanism which is working for the purpose of adding element into hashset. Anyone from this class have gone for how this mechanism? Yesterday I have given you an assignment that how it has been added. Anyone has done or not? Is there such care can anyone
has tried or not? Okay, let it be. I will share the video of how this hashing mechanism algorithm is working. So whenever you are adding this element in the hash set, the mechanism I have used this 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 5. This I have used, but when I go for retrieving these elements, you will find that 5 is been displayed first. So left row node, right node, on that mechanism it has been stored, and I will share this video after this. So you will get an output like this: 5, 1, 4, 2, and then 3. Same way, when I add this 4 elements, and if there is a repeated elements, automatically it will store the unique value. Same type of programs what we have seen, just a revision for that. So whenever I have created a hashset, here you can create a hashset directly also. So there is no need for using a set. You can use a hashset also. Class also. So on the left hand side you can create directly, but it is always preferred to use only set as an interface. So set set is equal to new hash set. You can use that also, and this is another way of creating the hash set. Now you are adding Ravi, Vijay, Ravi and Ajay. These are the 4 elements, and you have find that Ravi is again repeated. If you write this Ravi in lowercase, it will consider it a separate entity because it is case sensitive. The values are being case sensitive. So if you are writing Ravi with uppercase and lowercase, all both the Ravis will be added over here. But here I have used Ravi in uppercase, so R here R same and all unique element only. So the repeated elements will be automatically removed. So we have already covered how for the purpose of adding, for the purpose of removing, then remove all. Then remove if you want to remove by checking the content value. So only remove can remove the element. Remove all will remove all the elements. And remove if will be deleting the element after checking that element. So that will be done by using a contains keyword. Same example here. Nothing different in this. I have created one array list. And I have created one hash set. I have added element Ravi, Vijay, and Ajay into array list. And I have passed an argument into this. So hash set can be created by using array list, linked list, or any list. So here I have passed this list as a variable. And what is this list? This list is nothing but an already it is an object. So the different type of constructor, this is a fourth type of constructor where we can add into hash set
direct values from your previous class, that is ArrayList class. So I have just passed this list object, and after that I have added some Gauru into this, and it has been displayed on the screen in the same way. So Vijay, Ravi, Gauru from the previous, these two one, Gauru from this set, and then after this Ajay. So whichever element is added, whether it is from previous class or you are added explicitly after your programming, all will be following one technology, that is hashing for adding elements. So hashing is the most important part within this hash set. So you have to know this everything. So same example, we'll go for the executing this example, and then after that we'll enter into link hash set. So this, it was a revision of the yesterday's work what we have done. So here hash set, we have added three countries, India, Australia and South Africa into this, and then after that I am again adding India into that. So I want to check whether it is repeated or not, and then after that I have removed that Australia from the list, and that has been displayed, and use an iterator for retrieving this element. Simple example, adding and removing element. Simple example, adding and removing, and again adding repeated elements. So previously we have added only three elements, that is India, Australia and South Africa, and you'll find that India is on the right hand side, Australia on the second hand, and this is on the left hand side. So it is added, then again I am adding India into that, it is found it is already there, so it will never get added, so only two elements will be displayed. Okay, this only four elements, three elements will be displayed, and when I go for removing this element Australia, so that will be removed directly from this, and for using iterator as a function, we can use hash next method and next method to retrieve the element, and as there are only two elements, so only South Africa and India will be displayed on your console. A very simple example where we are using only remove function and add function, and iterator as a function to retrieve those values. Simple example. Now this is enum. The here in this example we'll be using remove all, and again this remove if, this is the separate type of function. So here only remove, then remove all and remove if, these are the three types of function for removing elements. So we'll go for this example now. So here I am creating a hash set class object, name is object is set. I have added four elements to this. Set.add function is used for adding elements. So Ravi, Vijay, Arun and Sumit, these are the four elements I have added, and after adding I will display this set. After adding I will display this set, and after that I will use one remove function, very simple function, that is remove, and I will remove only one element, that is Ravi. So Ravi is there in this set, so it will be removed, and after removing we'll be displaying it on a screen. So after removing the element will be displayed. Now here I am creating a second set, second hash set, set one, and here I am adding two elements again, Ajay and Gauru. So now these are the two are added, and now what I will do is that I will concatenate this two set. I will concatenate this two set, that is set one. Set one is what? The current set and previous set. So parent set is set dot add all, will be adding two sets. So set one will be added with the set. So these two will be added and it will be stored into the object called as a set. So set will contain now set elements, all four elements, and plus these two elements. And we have already gone for removing this. So simple rule for adding with only values, and second one adding one predefined class object. So you can do by using this. You can create an array list also, no issue. You can use linked list also, no issue. So any class can be used which have an element in collection framework. So collection framework, any class can be used here in this example. Okay, then I am using remove all.
So again, remove all will be removing set dot remove all. So these two elements again will be removed. So by using remove all function, just like an array list, you can remove all the elements of that object also. So set one object, जो भी दो ऑब्जेक्ट थे हमारे पास दैट इज वाज अजय एंड गौरव विल बी रिमूव्ड ऑटोमेटिकली बाय यूजिंग अ फंक्शन कॉल्ड एज अ रिमूवर. सो रिमूव फंक्शन इज ओनली फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ रिमूविंग एन एलिमेंट. रिमूव ऑल इज फंक्शन फॉर रिमूविंग द ऑब्जेक्ट एलिमेंट्स. सो ऑल द ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑब्जेक्ट ऑल द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ दैट ऑब्जेक्ट विल बी रिमूव डायरेक्टली बाय यूजिंग रिमूव ऑल फंक्शन. एंड देन आफ्टर दैट After it will be displayed, the remove all will be displaying the remaining part of the element. And then there is a different type of remove if statement. So now this if statement is that it will check the element is present or not. If it is that, then only it will go for removing this element. So what is that one? So we'll go for str. What is str? What is str? I am creating an object variable called as str. And str dot contains what is str? Yes, I will run this program. So it will remove. It is a variable I have created, and I will just check for the contents. So it is, I think, set. I think so. I said there will be a compilation error. Right? Okay, it's still working. So this is a variable str. You can create any you can give any name. So the syntax is like this. This object will be go for removing only after executing this part. So if this part gets executed first, it will check the contents of this program, all the variables. It will check whether Vijay is there or not. If Vijay is there, then only that variable value will be passed over here, and that variable value will be removed by using remove if function. So here, if I get an example, that simple example. First time we have added four elements, it will be displayed four elements. Then after that, I am removing Ravi from this list. So we'll find after removing Ravi, we'll have only three elements. One Ravi is already removed. Then I am creating a next hash set, and I have added two elements. And using add all function, I am concatenating the set one and set two both. And as we see that there is no repeated element, so all elements will be directed. There is four elements, and already we have removed Ravi from this. So this have three elements, 3 + 2, 5 elements. So we'll get all five elements into this set of elements. Then I am using remove all function. And after remove all function, these two elements, because these are from set one, so set one two element, that is Ajay and Gauro, will be again removed. So in this example, you'll find this Ajay, it is not present in this list, and Arun, this is not again present to this. And remaining three elements, that is Vijay, Gauro, and Sumit. Vijay, Sumit will be displayed here, and Arun will be displayed here. Only two elements, that is Gauro and Ajay, these two elements have been removed. So we can remove this from remove all. And by using if statement, that is remove if statement, you can just retrieve these two values. That is, I have removed Vijay because after searching it, I found that Vijay is there, so it will be removed. And only two elements are there, that two elements will be displayed. And clear function will be removing all the elements from this list. So this is one example you have to remember, that is, we can remove with remove, or with remove all, and with remove if. So there are three different mechanisms. Add function, remove function will be accepting only elements, remove all will be accepting the object, and remove if will be accepting one string that will contains function, that will contain a function that will search the element whether it is present or not. If it is not, that if I am saying Vijay 1, I am saying Vijay 1, and as we know that this Vijay 1 is not present in the list, if I run this program, it will show it will do nothing. So it will do nothing. So there is no way of creating any runtime exception. So this technique is only used for the executing the elements by searching element, and if it is not found, it will not throw an exception. So explicitly it is being created for not generating an exception during a runtime. So for creating a program with flawless execution, it is always preferred to search element and then only go for the deleting that element. Directly haphazardly adding, removing the element will create some time, it may create some exception. So to not generate those exceptions, it is always preferred to go for remove if statement. So I think so you are clear with this example. Is everyone clear with this example? Is everyone clear with this example?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, same example I want to do. I want to show this separate different mechanism of hashset, where we can add a list already created, ready-made object that contains ready-made elements. We just want to use this class into your real-life example. And you want to use that object directly for adding. You don't want to waste your energy in creating again that hashset and all those things. So this is one example. I have created an array list of three elements, and these three elements will be directly added into this by using calling that object itself. And then explicitly we can add our own personal elements can be added at your runtime also. So this thing can be done by using this called as array list object, and that object as a passing into your hashset object. So we'll run this program. So previously we have added Vijay, Ravi and RJ. So these three elements are already there. And here I am adding Gauru, and I have used iterator as a function to retrieve those values. So all four values will be displayed on a separate line, and you can use the previous object also. This is one example of constructor of this hash set, that you can use another class object also. So now we'll stop with the hash set, and we'll start with another type of hash set, that is a linked hash set. This is another type of link hash set. So now what is link hash set? Now link hash set is another type of class which is present under the same interface called as a set. Another same interface called as a set. You'll see in a diagram, it is been denoted in the orange color below the hash set. So this is again a class that implement this interface. So you have to keep in mind, this is the same. This is called the sibling of your hashset class. So these are both are siblings. Now the mechanism of this and what are the important things about this hashset. Now see what is the difference between hashset and linked hashset. Java link hashset class is a hash table. It is nothing but it is not a set. Now it is a table. This is nothing but a hash table, and linked list implements all the set interface. So linked list implements the set interface. It inherit has set class. It inherit has set class and implements set interface. So link has set is a child of has set. Now here all the elements are added into set. Now here it will be added in the format of hash table. So what is link has set? Link has set is nothing but adding elements in a form of a tree or a table. Sorry. So this hierarchy you have to understand. You have to understand that iterable, collection, and set, these are the three interfaces. Then the class which is implementing all these features, that is abstract set. And previously what we have learned, that is hash set, it is implemented from this abstract set. And this link hash set, it is nothing but the child of this hash set itself. So this is the most important thing. And when we talk about the important part about linked hashset, what is the most unique things about this linked hashset is that Java link hashset class contains unique elements only like hashset. So it is just like as it is a child of hashset, so it will only contain the unique values. So only unique elements will be added into this linked hashset. Then Java link hashset class provide all options, set operations, and permits null elements. Just like a previous example, it will do all operations just like a hash set, and it also permit, it should all, it will always allow the addition of a null value. So null value can be added into this linked hash set. Then again, it is linked hash set is non-synchronous. You cannot synchronize. It is non-synchronous by default. And last one, linked hash set class maintain insertion order. So again, it's just like a hash set. It is following some mechanism called the hashing. And same hashing mechanism will be stored in the format of a tree, in a format of a table. So this is called as a hash table. So it will be stored in table format, and that can be retrieved using iterators itself. Now the name new thing is added into here is that it is linked hash set. Previously it was only hash set. Now it is linked hash set. It means
it will be implementing some mechanism of linked list. So here we are doing linked list. And what is the importance of linked list is that whenever you go for linked list, we consider this as a linked list, for example. So any linked list, whenever it is created, it knows the address of the next node. It always knows the address of the next node. And it always knows, if it is dumped linked list, it will also knows the address of the previous node. So knowing the no address of the next node and the previous node can only be done by the linked list. And as we have using the hash set with a new mechanism of linking with one another is been done by this linked hash set. So that's why it is somewhat different from the previous one. Now, what is the syntax of this? It's very simple syntax in that it is a public class linked hash set that extends hash set. Now we are extending one class called as a hash set. So all the features of hash set that previously what we have seen all comes into this, and it implements three different types of interface. That is, one is set, one is clonable and serializable. So this all three interfaces will be implemented into this linked list, linked hash set automatically. So what is most important is that it contains unique elements only like hash set. Just like hash set, it can add unique elements, and it extends hash set class and implements set interface. So one more benefits of this. And second one is that it maintains order, insertion order. So whenever you are adding any element, it will be added in a very systematic way, not haphazard. Insertion will be done into the hash set. So the way you have added and the way you get an output will be always different into this linked hash set. What is the syntax of creating a linked hash set? Very simple. Linked hash set string. Because we are restricting to add only a string, the name of the object and new keyword link has set, and again a string. One second. Now these are the ways of creating. So these are the types of constructor. Again, we'll go for the size constructor. So linked is by default, it is linked has set, as we know that a has set has a size of 16. So maybe 16 itself. So this is a default constructor for creating a linked list. Linked has set. Now second way that previously we have seen, a ready-made object can be again be used. Your value for this constructor will be your collection, any classes. So you can use array list, linked list, any class can be used for creating a linked has set. Then third parameter, you can restrict the size also. So if you want a linked hash set of only 10 or 15 or 20, any number can be added into this. And third one, a linked hash set with capacity. So you can give us capacity over here also. So that can be occupied or it cannot be occupied. So these are the four types of constructor of your linked hash set. Now this was the new things what I have talked about, this splitrator. Now iterator, you know. Now this is splitrator. Splitrator is a method creates a late binding and fail fast splitrator over the elements in the last element. So we'll go for example of that, what is exactly happening here also. So there are clear function also and contained function also. You can use any type of function. So in link has said there is a splitrator, clear and contained. So question mark is already it has been added from my side, but there is no need of adding this question mark. So it is just for the purpose, you should know the three types of function are added into this linked hash set. This is most important. So you have to keep in mind that duplications are not allowed here in this linked hash set, and the insertion order is preserved. Linked hash set is widely used in building cache based applications. So your cache based application. So whenever you want to add an element into cache, so that time linked hash set values have been added. So very simple example how to create an object. And as we know that this class is present in util package, we need to import this util package. So I have imported this package java.util.star and created a linked hash set class object. The name of the object is set, and using a new keyword we have created this linked hash set, and we have added this elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we have used this iterator function for the purpose of displaying those values. So we go for execution after that and we get this values. Same example, you can create object of different values. So previous example was 1, 2, 3, 4. Same way we can see that repeated elements that Ravi will not be added. Only three elements will be added. That is Ravi, Vijay and Ajay. This duplicate element will not be added. This is one example. We'll check whether it is adding a unique values or not. Then we'll be adding one object. This example will be doing that. We'll be adding this object into this all book elements values, that's book ID, name, author, publication, and quantity. Or in a previous example, what we have done, we'll be adding into this linked hash set, just like an array list or linked list. Same, it can be done in a linked hash set also. So we'll be going for the executing the same program, and then after that, we'll be stopping with this linked hash set. So these two things, three, four programs will go for execution, and you will find that is similar, just like the previous example. So we are going for linked hash set. So this is a simple example, how to create an object, how to add an element, and how to retrieve those elements. How to create an object of a class, how to add those elements, and how to retrieve these elements. So very simple example. And I think there is no need to repeatedly explain those code, because you can understand it, because we have ample number of examples. So now see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be added into this. So all this, and how this is displayed in same for format. Abhi ye aapka research karne kaam hai. I am telling you that how this has been added. So we'll get an output like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have used add function, and we have used iterator for retry those elements. Simple example of creating an object. Now second example. Now here I have created duplicate values. So Ravi is added twice, and here the purpose of writing this code is very simple. We want to check whether the unique values are added or repeated values are allowed in linked hash set or not. Very simple example. We'll go for running this program. So we'll find that Ravi, it has been added twice, but only once it will be added into linked hash set. So uniqueness will be maintained by linked hash set, like a hash set. Okay, the second example. And for third example, now this is one a big example, so I will go for explaining this part in a very simple way. So as we are doing the package, we will be using ready-made classes. So I have used this util package for using some ready-made classes which are present in this util package. Very simple class I have created. So this class I have created explicitly. Whenever I go for running this program, you will find this is the left side, these two classes has been created. So what it will do is that it will create a dot class file of this separately and dot class file of this separately. So as we know, there are two classes. So there is a class book and one more class called an EXB. So we'll get two different types of classes. So in this class, only we are adding some variables. So as I want to store in a format of a data structure, I want to store in the format of structure. So I have used ID for book ID, name, author, and publisher. Name, author, and publisher. I will store in the format of string. So that is why string data type. And I want to get some quantity of those books. So that will be my five variables I will be displaying. ID, name, author, publication, and quantity. And its data type, integer, string, and integer. I have created this constructor, and it is parameterized constructor. So I will be accepting some values, and I will be assigning those values to my current object. So the number I created the object, as soon as I create object, automatically this keyword will be assigning the name of that object to this keyword. So that value will be added into that concern object variable only. So as I have passed this value, it will be coming here. And then after that, it will be added into that corresponding object only. So if I'm creating 10 objects, so 10 book classes will be executed. So 10 times this book class will get executed. I'm creating 3 here, so only 3 times this book class will be executed automatically. So this is one simple example of creating a class, creating a constructor, and assigning those values to those constructors. Now second class that will be calling for the as a remote, that will be executing this class multiple times. So here I'm creating a link hash set. And in this link hash set, I am restricting to add only book object only. So there is no string, no integer, no float, though, no character. I am restricting the program to add only a book. And what is book? Book is nothing but a class. So that class will be added over here into this. So it will now accept only those object only. So the book object only will be added into this. So now we'll be calling this and we'll be assigning some values. So how to create an object of this class and how to assign those values? Very simple. I have used the book class because it is already with the name called as a book. So book class B1 is equal to new book, and I have passed these five parameters. So ID will be here. So 101 will be ID. Let us see double quote. I am dividing this two content by using a comma. So comma is used for the purpose of delimiting this two different elements. So let us see the name of program that will be passed with the name of a string. Then Yashwant Kanetkar is the author, so it will be passed in the author variation. So that will be transferred to this publication string, and the quantity in which I want to purchase this books, so that will be transferred to the quantity. Same way, book two to the this same class. Same way, B3, that is object 3 of operating system 103, will be transferred into this constructor. And now this will be executing three times, and three different objects with three different values will be stored. Now by using this add function, HS, what is HS? HS is nothing but the hash, linked hash set. And I'm adding now this object. So I'm not adding variables. Now I'm adding book 1, book 2, and book 3. So these three will be added automatically into this linked hash set. And the purpose for retrieving this is nothing but traversing the hash set. And this is done by the enhanced for loop. Very simple. Return type, as we are returning a hash set value, and as hash set we have added an object. So this hash set will be returning the object itself. So agar aapne object dal diya to aapko output mein object hi milega. And I will be in the left hand side, so I have to give the name of this object class. So the object class is book. So again I am using a book, and here I am giving any name. So you can give any name. So here I have given a B as a name of this object. And I am, as soon as this is, it has been retrieved, it will go for navigating the element, and it will be transferring to this book class object called as a B. And I here by using B.id, B.name, B.author, B.publisher, B.quantity, and this name are not pre-generated. You have not generated. It is already written here. So if I'm clicking this one publisher, so it should be same as just what you have declared in the class. So it is predefined, already written by somebody else. So you'll be using this one. So if I'm saying ID, so it is already there in the book. So same name of the variables will be accessed automatically, and all the values will be displayed on a screen. So we'll go for running this program. It's a very simple program. We have gone on the same scenario. We have executed multiple programs. But just we want to use the same phenomena of adding an object using linked hash set. So you'll find this three elements, three objects will be displayed on a screen with the help of this iterator. This for loop, and this for loop is nothing but an enhanced for loop. Are you getting? Is everyone getting this one? How we
yes,
are
sir.
Adding we are adding this object into linked hash set. Now we'll go for the last example. Here we'll be using multiple functions. So size function, remove function, and will be used for the purpose of adding. So here what we have done is that with simple object of linked hash set, and we have added a variables value like A, B, C, D. And again, we have added a repeated value. So repeated A already is there. It will be, we are again adding that A, and again, we are adding E, which is not present. And getting a size. Now, what is the size of this that will be displayed? So previously we have four elements. Then after that, we are adding two elements. So size should be 6. But as it don't allow repeated values, so size will be 5. So we'll go for that also. So we'll go directly for running this program. So see, though we have added 4 plus 2, 6 elements, the size is 5. Because only unique values will be displayed. And that unique values, you will get that A, B, C, D, E will be only displayed by using this. So size function will be giving the size of your linked hash set. Now remove function. If I want to remove this function from, I want to remove some element from this, so I can use this remove function like the previous example we have seen. So it always return
value called as a true and false. The basic purpose of running this program is that whenever you are using remove function, its return type is always true or false. So it is displaying as D is already present into this list, so that will be removed and the value will be displayed as true. So after removing it, it will be showing a true value. Then trying to remove Z. As Z is not there in a string, not there in a linked asset, so it will it has returned false value. So we have received false value because Z is not there in this linked asset. And next one, contains, for searching the element into this list. So I want to check whether A is present in the list or not. So contains keyword is only for the purpose of searching the element. So A is there, so it will return true value. So contains function. Function always return a boolean data type value that is true or false. If it is there, it will show true, will be displaying those values. So your contents will not remove that element, it will only check that element. So after displaying this, you will find that A is there, true, but it is not removed. So contents never remove the element, only remove function removes the element from the hash linked hash set. So is everyone getting one? Simple examples we have gone
yes,
for
sir.
Linked hash set. Okay. So tomorrow my lecture will be there. Tomorrow my lecture will be there, and tomorrow we'll go for